गाइस, वेलकम टू द चैनल द ब्रेनस्टॉर्मर। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी एसक्यूएल कमांड्स। सो वी डिवाइडेड इट इन फाइव कैटेगरीज: डाटा डेफिनेशन लैंग्वेज, डाटा मैनिपुलेशन लैंग्वेज, डाटा कंट्रोल लैंग्वेज, ट्रांजेक्शन कंट्रोल लैंग्वेज एंड डाटा क्वेरी लैंग्वेज। सो अंडर डाटा डेफिनेशन लैंग्वेज वी हैव फोर कमांड्स लाइक क्रिएट कमांड, अल्टर कमांड, ट्रंकेट कमांड एंड ड्रॉप कमांड। अंडर डाटा मैनिपुलेशन लैंग्वेज वी हैव इंसर्ट कमांड, अपडेट कमांड एंड डिलीट कमांड। अंडर डाटा कंट्रोल लैंग्वेज वी हैव ग्रांट एंड रिवॉक। एंड अंडर ट्रांजेक्शन कंट्रोल लैंग्वेज वी हैव सेव पॉइंट, रोल बैक एंड कमिट। And at last, we have data query language, which consists of select command. Then coming to data definition language. So data definition language changes the structure of the table, like creating a table, deleting a table, or altering a table. So all the commands of DDL are auto-committed. That means it permanently saves all the changes made in the database. So we have four commands under DDL: create, alter, drop and truncate. So we will go through that one by one. So first we have create command. So it is used to create a new table in the database. So for this we have syntax: create, then we write table, then the table name, and under the brackets we have the column name with the data type. So example, we have create table employee, then we have column name name here, and data type is varK2, and we passed 20 value here. Then we have another column name email, which consists of varK2, data type and 100. Then we have date of birth, and it's a date data type. Then we close the bracket and we have semicolon. Now we have alter command. This is used to alter the structure of the database. So we have two types of syntax there. The first syntax is to add new column in the table. Like first we alter table name, then we add column name here, and then column definition we are providing. So example, we can say alter table, then table name is student details, then we add here new column. So it column here, column name is address, and data type we are mentioning as varK2 with definition as 20. Another syntax is to modify existing column in the table. First one is to add a new column in the table, and second one is to modify the existing column in the table. So syntax for that is alter table name, modify, then we under the bracket we specify what the column definition, like data type and all. So example, you can see alter table student detail, modify, then we are passing name as column name, and varK2 as 20. So we modified existing column here. Existing column means name is there already, so we updated it with another, like from 10 to 20 we updated, or from like integer to varK2, like that we updated. So now we have third command is drop command. So it is used to delete both the structure and the record stored in the table. So for that we have two types of syntax there. First one is to drop the table, so drop the table and then table name and semicolon. Second syntax is for drop database and the database name. Example, we have corresponding to both syntax. So for first we have drop table employee, and for database we used drop database student. Now we have truncate command. So it is used to delete all the rows from the table and free the space containing the table. So syntax for this is truncate table, then table name. Example, we can see truncate table employee. Now we have DML, data manipulation language. So DML commands are used to modify the database. It is responsible for all forms of changes in the database. So it mainly deals with the database, not with the structure. Like inside the table we need to deal with. So command of DML is not auto committed. That means it can't permanently save all the changes in the database. They can be rolled back. So we have three commands under that: insert command, update command, and delete command. So we will look into that delete command. So it is used to remove one or more rows from a table. Syntax we have delete from table name, then where condition we need to specify. Example, we can check delete from student. Student here is table name, and then we are using where condition, where name is Karthik. So it will delete the row which consists name as Karthik from the student table. Now we have insert command. It is used to insert data into the row of a table. So we have two syntax there, like insert into table name. Then we have column 1, column 2, column 3, up to n column. Then we need to pass the values, like value 1, value 2, value 3, up to n. Then syntax 2 is for insert into table name. Just pass values here, value 1, 2, 3. No need to pass here column name, the second syntax. So we can use both, any of one we can use. Example, we can see insert into student name, comma city, where values equals to Mohit and Goa. So it will insert into student table into row, into column name and column name city, with values is equals to Mohit as name and city as Goa. Then we have update command. This command is used to update or modify the value of a column in the table. So we have syntax for that: update table name, then set we need to use, then we need to pass column name with value, and then we have where condition. So we have that example here: update students is table name, then we need to pass set where column name equals to Aman, where roll number equals to 7. So in student table we are passing updating name with the Aman where roll number is 7. So at the place where roll number is 7, corresponding to it, name will be changed to Aman. Then we have data control language, DCL. So DCL commands are used to grant and take back authority from any database user. So we have two commands under it: grant and revoke. So grant command, so it is used to give user access privilege to a database. Example, we can see grant select update on my table name to some user or another user. So we are passing giving access on particular database to some persons. Then we have revoke command. It is used to take back permission from the user. So once we give permission to users with grant command, we just need to roll back. So we take back that permission. So we use here revoke select update on my table, like table name, from user 1, comma 2. So to whomever we gave that permission, so we are just taking them back from them. Then we have transaction control language. Transaction control language can only use with DML commands like insert, delete, and update. So for using the TCL command, we need to have a DML command link with them. So these operations are automatically committed in the database. That's why they cannot be used while creating tables or dropping them. So we have three types of commands under TCL: commit command, rollback, and save point. Commit command. Commit command is used to save all the transactions to the database. Syntax we write commit with semicolon. So we just need to use with the DML commands as we specify. So here DML command is delete from customer where age is equals to 285. Then in the next line we pass commit to save all the transaction till here. Then we have rollback command. rollback command is used to undo transaction that have not already been saved to database. So syntax for that is rollback semicolon. So DML command is delete from customer where age is equal to 25. Then in next line we specify rollback semicolon. So it will use to undo the transaction. As with the name we can say rollback. So it will revert to that first position from where we started. Then we have save point command. It is used to roll the transaction back to a certain point without rolling back to the entire transaction. Like we just need save point to save till that point, to that certain point our work. Like it will not roll back to the starting position. Instead it will roll back to that save point. So save point, we need to pass command save point and then save point underscore name for the name column. Then we have data query language. DQL is used to fetch the data from the database. So we use select command there. Select command is same as the projection operation of the relational algebra. It is used to select attribute based on the condition described by where clause. So syntax, we have two types of syntax here, like select expression from tables where condition. Another one is to select asterisk from the table name. So example, we can see select employee name from employee where age is greater than 20. And another type we can select star from student. So it will select all the, it will give all the columns from the table, all the information from the table. In the first one we will get the employee name from the employee table, and in the second one we will get all the columns with the values. Then we have difference between drop, truncate and delete. So drop is used to delete a database table or view. Truncate is used to delete all the rows from a table, and delete is used to delete a row in the table. Data cannot be rolled back in drop. Data cannot be rolled back in truncate also, but data can be rolled back to delete command. It is a DDL command, both truncate and drop, while delete is a DML command. Drop is slower than truncate, and truncate is faster than drop and delete, and delete is slower than truncate. So truncate is much faster than both drop and delete, and drop will delete the full structure of the table. Truncate will preserve the structure of the table, but it will delete all the rows from the table, and last one will delete the structure of row from a table. So yeah, thank you so much.